Three teens strolled along a beach. The afternoon sun rays glimmered off the waves.
The king sure knows how to throw a party,
exclaimed the brown-haired boy.
You said it, Sora,
agreed the girl with a giggle.
Can you imagine, Kairi?
Sora exclaimed.
Soon there will be a travel system between the worlds. Then we'll be able to see all our friends whenever we want to.
You mean a transit system?
The taller boy corrected with a chuckle.
I think you've been with your other friends too long. You're starting to sound like them.
Sora put his hands behind his head.
Aw, come on, Riku.
It's only the truth,
the boy replied. The trio crossed a bridge to arrive at the crooked papu fruit tree. It was their favorite spot to watch sunsets together. Sora and Kairi sat up on the bent tree, while Riku stood and leaned against the trunk. They gazed out across the waves, waves that they used to wonder what was beyond them, but now they knew. Breathing in the sea air, they reminisced about times from before they learned about the other worlds out there. It wasn't that long ago since they had been separated and thrown across the universe, but after all they went through, it was hard to recall what their former lives were like.
Remember when we were trying to build that dinky little raft?
Sora asked.
Who built it? You guys were frolicking in the sand while I did all the work,
Riku reminded. The other two looked sheepish, knowing his accusation was accurate. Kairi finally spoke up.
I'll never forget that. It was right before our world disappeared.
That's the thing,
Sora explained.
We built that raft so we could find the place in your memories from before you came here. I just realized, in all our adventures, we found your original home, Kairi.
I suppose that's true,
Kairi agreed. Having gathered the Ansem reports and secret Ansem reports on their journey, they had learned that Kairi came from another world called Radiant Garden. She was one of the Seven Princesses of Heart, and as an experiment, was sent to Destiny Island to see the interaction with one who could wield the Keyblade.
Aerith said that Radiant Garden was looking better than ever now. We'll have to go back so you can see it, Kairi,
Sora offered.
You know, it's nice to know where I came from, but now that I know that, I don't mind staying here with you guys.
They all looked out at the sun. Riku crossed his arms with a slight frown.
Do you really think all this will last?
Riku pondered. Sora forced a look of pain on his face.
Oh no. Look who's being philosophical again.
Kairi giggled at Sora's antics. She almost fell off the bent trunk, but he caught her hand and pulled her back up.
Laugh all you guys want,
Riku said with little amusement.
But we haven't really tried to live here since our adventures. It may not be as easy as we think it'll be.
Still worried about facing everyone after what you did?
Sora chided. Riku looked away from his friends. Before, he had let the darkness overtake him in his heart. It was essentially his fault that their world was destroyed in the first place. Then, to add to it, he was possessed by a man claiming to be Ansem. This was really the Heartless of the real Ansem's apprentice, Xehanort. In the end, Riku was able to overpower the Heartless's control, but he still held regrets over what happened through him. Sora thought about something that could cheer his friend up. He leaned towards Riku when an idea struck.
What if we catch up with Tidus, Waka, and Selfie tomorrow and have an ultimate showdown?
What did you say?
Riku looked up at Sora.
Let's have a match with our old friends. That'll bring back the good old times.
You just made yourself sound like an old fogey.
Riku smirked, waving his hand. Kairi smiled and placed a hand on Riku's shoulder.
Don't worry. I came back here when this world was first restored and was able to get along fine. We'll be all right,
Kairi soothed.
As long as we're together.